I had no medical history, no doctors monitoring anything. I was normal and perfectly healthy. In fact, I was actually extremely active. I had been an aerobics instructor and had a baby naturally 6 months before. And I had been doing some commercial prep modeling. So I was at like Target ads and, you know, sweet little catalog work. And anyway, I technically was paying the bills. But yeah, that was obviously a vast change for me to have been paid for my appearance, basically, and then to have a paralyzed face and have that happen overnight. I'm a stroke survivor, and that's why I'm severely disabled, and my hand won't work, and my face is paralyzed, and I can't walk, and I can't drive, and I'm deaf in one ear, and my eyes don't track, and I have all these health problems. You'd think that's because I had a stroke. But actually, it's not. I am disabled because the wise and careful surgeon chose to sacrifice things in order for me to sustain life. So it's really, really, really powerful to think that in my deep wounding, my healing could come. I was kind of down deep for like 5 years, honestly, of my new normal. And I think that's awesome. I think we need to give each other permission to like not be okay for a while when terrible suffering happens. Once I had like relearned to eat and speak and walk and sort of could start to wake up to just a bigger picture here, I was able to kind of recognize a couple things. One, that my story of overcoming would become someone else's survival guide down the road. And that was very powerful to think that maybe a young mom who's in a wheelchair needs to know that there is life on the other side of this. There's this crazy freedom. No one's trying to worship at the idol of a pain-free life. Instead, people are like, there is pain in our stories, and we can still experience joy in those same stories, and we're here for that. We're so obsessed with the life we thought we would have that we can't wake up to the life that's right in front of our noses, honestly. We're like, but wait, when I was 4 years old, I really thought this was gonna be my life, but now I was 37 years old. If I was obsessed with that, it would be really sad right now. But I'm not. My four-year-old dreams, bye-bye. My 37-year-old dreams are here to stay, and they're awesome. This is my life, and I have the opportunity to love this and to champion it really well, even though it's never the story I would have chosen or written. Like, I can recognize and wake up to the life right in front of me is the best life. Honestly, we cannot control what happens to us, a lot of it. We cannot control. But what we do have control over is how we respond to it. We have control over how we respond, how we think about it, and ultimately we have a huge responsibility to remember it correctly. For instance, in my own life, post-stroke, I've had to have a lot of really bad surgeries, 11 actually, a lot of just like very real difficult pain. And I can be really scared. And yet, I know too much to be really scared. Like, I don't die. I get through surgeries. I come out the other side. And there is such a comfort in remembering well where you are today. And that is, that's something we all have the opportunity to do, is that we are where we are today by what happened. What a powerful thought for us. Like, maybe all the bad stuff is being used in such a powerful way to inform how we live this life. You know, I fancy myself a joy rebel. I am rebelling with joy. And that is something we entirely have the ability to do, is no matter how hard our stories are, we get to be the joy rebel. Don't miss the life right in front of you, even if it's not the life that you ever imagined when you were a little girl. You have the power to re-narrate what's happening in your life. We all need a little less pity and honestly self-absorption and an outward focus. I don't have time to worry so much about like the details that didn't work out right in my story, because I've got a laser focus on making others' lives better. And it's crazy because it fuels you. It fuels how you feel about your life. When you know you're impacting other people, it changes how you experience your story.